In a world where 2.5 quadrillion bytes of data is created every day, it's not surprising that organizations want to harness the power of being data-driven. In our 2022 Data Health Barometer, 99% of companies surveyed recognize that data is crucial for success, but 97% said they face challenges in using data effectively. 65% of companies reported they started a data literacy program. Maybe you've been tasked with starting a data literacy program, or maybe you have read the research and want to be the champion of data literacy for your organization. Hi, I'm Bethany Gripp, the Senior Data Governance Analyst at Talend. And in this video, I'll walk you through starting a data literacy pilot with six phases that can be scaled once you have traction and prove your value. Look at you already being data-driven. Let's start with phase one, planning and vision. The first question that might come to mind is who should own the program? We have typically seen data literacy programs reside within the CDO office, but every organization is different. If you don't have a CDO, it might belong with IT or another centralized data office. In our case, our data literacy program originated from our centralized data office, which includes governance, data management, and analytics all in one team. As with any initiative, you should start by defining your end goals. What is it that you want to achieve by having a data literacy program? Let's start with the vision. Being data literate means that employees can read, interpret, and understand data in context. Context is foundational. How can an employee read data in context without knowing the context of their data? Or, said in another way, where does your data come from? Who or what uses it? How is it created or transformed? Governance tools are important in laying the foundation of data literacy because it provides that metadata management or the data about your data. Focusing on this foundation can help you identify your stakeholders and pilot participants and also show the value your program can bring. Next, what tools exist within your organization or need to be procured to achieve those goals? Your participants will need a user-friendly access to data with tools that provide enough data context while also protecting your sensitive data. Once you have defined the data roles and responsibilities, the goals, and the tools for your data literacy pilot, you can build the rest of your framework around it. Your framework should be monitored, iterative, and scalable. In our program at Talend, we decided to start at the foundation, the data context level, and enrich our metadata through gathering tribal knowledge. So we started with our analysts who work with the data day in and day out. We communicated the value of their knowledge, not just to new team members that might join their team, but to all employees across the organization who want to make better decisions based on the analyst work. Phase two, communication. You'll need to share your vision with the organization. You don't want the value of data literacy or news of your data literacy program to be limited to the pilot participants. Making a concerted effort to let the organization know the pilot is kicking off will increase awareness and buy-in when you want to onboard more teams. Partner with your internal communications team to generate excitement about your program. Phase three, increasing access with the right access. Whatever the goals of your program are, you'll need to give employees access to the data you're training them to use. Is that data well understood, documented, trusted? We recommend focusing on a tool that helps you answer those questions and provides a means for data shopping, or what's sometimes called a data mart. Further, you'll need a way to govern access through policies and other authentication tools. But more importantly, you can't just give access to all data, especially protected data. This is where data masking and encryption can be useful. And many users will need more than just read-only access. You'll want them to be involved in the data stewardship activities and be able to share data with one another. Phase four, enablement. It isn't enough to have access to data and tools, but you'll also need to enable your participants. The effort involved could be minimal if you're using a tool that's easy to adopt, or if they already is used within the organization. On the other hand, if your tools have a steep learning curve, you might have to develop trainings yourself. Either way, it'll be great if your organization has an intranet site or a central location for employee trainings. Phase 5, sustaining adoption via building a data culture. You'll need to maintain sustained adoption and continuous learning. This is where it's helpful if you already have a one-stop shop for employee trainings. I recommend regular syncing meetings with your participants and providing tips and tricks on a weekly basis of new ways to discover data. You can also gamify the experience, giving participants badges or kudos for enriching metadata or completing learning plans. Sustaining adoption creates a data culture within your organization, one that promotes the value and the use of data to improve decision-making. Phase 6, evaluating and reiterating. Your program will get better and smoother as you learn from your own experience. I recommend that you assess the participants' knowledge prior to the start of the program, midway, and then at the close of the program to measure the impact and the value. You'll want to include measures to assess the change management process as well. A great methodology to follow is the ACAR method, which assesses if a participants are at the awareness, desire, knowledge, ability, or reinforcement stage of change management. Scaling up. The progress of your pilot and success stories that come out of it will help build the momentum to scale the program to other business units. You could also increase the scope of the program to build employee skills on data analysis, storytelling with data, and data visualizations, or any other data competencies relevant to your industry. I hope this video was helpful to those starting out on a data literacy path. Check the links below or visit talend.com to find more resources to help guide you on your journey.